It's time for Yankton Gazelles basketball on 5-Star Communications and with YouTube on 5-Star Streaming. Yankton basketball is brought to you by FNBO. For more than 160 years, First National Bank has maintained its commitment to helping to build strong communities. Yankton basketball is also brought to you by the South Dakota High School Activities Association and our Yankton Sportscaster sponsors. Tip-off is coming up shortly, but for now, here's the voice of Yankton basketball. It's Joe Van Goor.
Well, good evening and howdy again, everyone, along with Michael Schumacher. Casey Miners is our studio engineer and our Yankton Sportscaster Club members that bring you Bucks and Gazelles Athletics here on 5-Star Communications. We welcome you to the high school gym at Sioux Falls Washington High School in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, where tonight the Yankton Gazelles 0-2 step out of the Eastern South Dakota Conference and take on the defending AA champions, Sioux Falls Washington Warriors, who are 1-0 on the season. They are members of the Metro Conference. This is the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. The Yankton Medical Clinic, so much care, so close to home. And Yankton High School Basketball presented by First National Bank Omaha. FNBO with full-service banking, mortgage, ag, commercial, small business, free checking, savings and credit cards, your great big small bank. Last Tuesday, on the road in ESD action, Yankton led Huron 43-40 late in the game, but Huron with a 6-0 run to defeat the Gazelles 46-43. Ellie Karlovitz led the Gazelles last Tuesday with 14 points. The last time these two teams met was on December 28th of 2020, just after Christmas. Sioux Falls, Washington defeated Yankton 69-27. Jack Yolinga Wendentata had 14 points to lead Washington. Off the bench, Alexis Motley had 14 points. You'll see both of those gals on the floor tonight for Sioux Falls, Washington. For Yankton, Jordan Salvatore had 6 points. And the South Dakota Prep Media basketball poll in Class AA girls has Sioux Falls, Washington number one, Brandon Valley second, O'Gorman third, Stevens fourth, Harrisburg fifth, with Rapid City Central receiving votes. When we come back on the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic, we'll talk about Sioux Falls, Washington and their coach, Yankton High School graduate and Augustana University graduate Jamie Parrish. We'll be back in 1 minute. This is Gazelles Basketball on Classic Hits 106.3, online at kvhtradio.com and on 5-Star Streaming from YouTube.
Ready to make your mouth water? Just look at the screen. That's Bro Burger Bar, 304 West 3rd Street, Yankton.
Why choose Floortech Restoration? They provide many services for residential and commercial properties like carpet cleaning, mold testing and removal, fire and smoke damage, water damage and duct cleaning. Locally owned and operated since 1994, Floortech Restoration also offers 24-hour emergency service in Yankton, Mitchell, Southeast South Dakota, Northeast Nebraska, and Norfolk. When the floor is wet, call Floortech.
Free clothing.
Back in Sioux Falls at the Warrior Gym, it's Yankton at 0-2 against top-ranked Sioux Falls, Washington, who's 1-0. Washington, 20-2 last season, won the AA championship, the third championship for head coach Jamie Parrish, who's in his eighth year, a graduate of not only Yankton High School, but Augustana University. He won a title with Vermilion High School in 2007 and won, as we mentioned, the AA title last year in 2021 and also in 2015. He is assisted by Alicia Hess, Grant Scouten, Michaela Mayer, Sydney Arrington, and Daly Stain. Of course, Washington returns the outstanding University of Texas commit, Jocalinga Menwantata, who averaged almost 15 points, averaged 7 rebounds, had almost 2.5 assists and almost 2 steals a game to lead Sioux Falls Washington in their first game of the season. Washington defeated Sioux Falls Lincoln by the final of 70-45. The Warriors shot 38% in that game, 28% from three, and 59% from the free throw line. They had 55 rebounds in the game, 19 assists, 11 steals, 6 blocked shots, and 17 turnovers. Leading Washington in that game was Brooklyn Harp with 17 points, and Wentanada had 16. Leading rebounder was Taylor Thompson, as she had 11. So that's the latest on Sioux Falls, Washington, here on the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show, brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. When we come back, we'll talk with Yankton girls head basketball coach Trey Creer. This is Yankton High School Basketball on Classic Hits 106.3. We'll be back in a minute.
Seasons Power Sports in Yankton can help make your life easier and more fun. All Seasons Power Sports can help you with ATVs, side-by-sides, fishing and pleasure boats, as well as motorcycles, watercraft, and more. Check out their inventory at AllSeasonsPowerSportsInc.com. All Seasons Power Sports, your authorized Honda and Yamaha dealer, on your way to the lake in Yankton.
Fuller Digital Solutions started small, but now we're growing as FDS provides live streaming coverage for over 20 schools across 3 different states on our Fuller Digital Solutions YouTube channel. Subscribe to get notified when we go live for your school events. Big events are captured live, and your business can get noticed with advertising during our live streams. Local talent and camera operators are encouraged to contact us too for future employment. No experience necessary. We will train. For information about advertising or working with Fuller Digital Solutions, email us and follow us on Facebook.
Dental and vision benefits in partnership with Colonial Life. Skip the voicemail and go with the Antrobus Agency.
Back on the Gazelle Basketball Pregame Show, Yankton is coached by Trey Creer, who's in his 8th year, a graduate of Mount Marty University. He is assisted by Amy Long, Jill Muth, and Zach Hoover. And Coach Creer and I sat down earlier today to talk about the week of preparation for tonight's game with Sioux Falls, Washington. TK, well, Gazelles haven't played since last Tuesday at Huron. Got snowed out Friday against Harrisburg. So I'm sure after the Huron game last Tuesday, building on things for a big matchup tonight with the defending AA girls champion and top-ranked Sioux Falls, Washington.
Yeah, we're excited to get a chance to get back on the floor and see where we're at from last Tuesday at Huron. We had some things that we needed to talk about in particularly the end of the game situation, and now we get a chance to go up against the defending state champs in Sioux Falls, Washington, who present their own set of things that we need to make sure that we focus on and find a way to compete for 4 quarters.
Yep, defending champion Sioux Falls, Washington, who's 1-0 on the season after a win against Sioux Falls Lincoln last Friday night. And people are saying this may be a better Washington team than last year. Of course, they have returned an outstanding player that's going to the University of Texas to play women's basketball, but they lost 4 starters. But obviously it's a case of reloading for the Warriors. Instead of, one starter back and you see what happens.
Yeah, you know, and what, part of what made them so good last year was that they had those kids who came off the bench who were able to not skip a beat. You know, they got the Harp twins, very, very potent scorers, have the ability to score from range as well as get to the basket, which just makes things more difficult in terms of trying to keep Jacalinga off the boards and trying to keep her from getting to the basket. So I think you're absolutely right. I think they have the potential of being, you know, the top team in the state again, and we have to be able to find ways to not only guard the perimeter, but to keep them off the board. They got a big girl who complements Jacalinga on the inside, who is going to be difficult for us to make sure we're securing defensive rebounds. We talked a lot yesterday in practice about making sure that we find a box out, get a body on somebody, and clear out some space. And you know, you mentioned Mentawanda, and she's a very talented kid, but she's proven in the past and in their first game that she will foul, and she will get herself in foul trouble, and the best way to probably guard her is to get her on the bench. So if we can find a way to be aggressive with her and make sure that we're putting pressure on her to make plays, that might be one of the best things for us tonight in terms of being able to compete.
And certainly offensively, you know, you have to guard against, I'm sure with the personnel that Coach Parrish has, they're going to put a lot of pressure on your gals offensively tonight.
Yeah, they've shown some press against Lincoln last week as well, which they've done in the past. They've got long arms. They put Jackalinga on the front of that and make it difficult to pass around them. And we need to be able to take care of the ball and at the same time be aggressive and match their aggression with some aggression of our own. And the more shots we can get up at the basket, the better chance we have of getting some of them to go in. So limiting some turnovers, which also limits their ability to get some runouts, easy baskets in transition. We gotta make sure we're getting our opportunities on the offensive end as well.
Coach Creer, thanks for the visit. Go get them, and we'll see you after the game.
Sounds good. Thanks, Joe.
Trey Creer. Trey Creer on the Gazelle Basketball pregame show brought to you by the Yankton Medical Clinic. The Yankton Medical Clinic, so much care, so close to home. In the sub-varsity games on the Fox Top scoreboard, in the JV game, Sioux Falls Washington won 57-39. In the sophomore game, Sioux Falls Washington won 62-14. And in the freshman game, Sioux Falls Washington defeated Yankton 45-19. Yankton, as a team, is averaging almost 38 points a game, shooting 31% from the floor, 22% from three, 43% from the free throw line, averaging 29 rebounds, 8 assists, 15 turnovers, and 8 steals. Folks, we'll be back with more of our pregame after this one-minute timeout here on Classic Hits 106.3, online at kvhtradio.com, and on 5-star streaming from YouTube. We'll be back in 1 minute.
At Avera, we believe good health starts early and that good health care can inspire a life of wellness. At Avera, we believe in push-ups and pumping iron. We believe less is more. And live for apple slices instead of apple pie. At Avera, we live for staying healthy and enjoying the little things. We're invested in healthy living so you can live longer.
Hear that? That's the sound of a well-oiled team hard at work, working on your ride at MW Towing and Automotive. They offer complete automotive and tire services. Plus, towing is in their name. MW Towing and Automotive offers 24-hour towing and roadside assistance. Call to schedule your appointment today at 605-668-9177. MW Towing, located 2.5 miles north of Walmart on Highway 81.
As we come back to the Warrior Gym, the last strains of our national anthem, there is a color guard provided by the Sioux Falls Washington Junior ROTC. They will be retiring the colors of our land and the South Dakota state flag, and then we'll continue with our pregame show here on Classic Hits 106.3 KVHT Vermilion Yankton, a proud service of 5-Star Communications, available online at kvhtradio.com, and tonight on Five Star Streaming from YouTube, along with our studio engineer, Casey Miners. Also, our Yankton Sportscaster Club members, Michael Schumacher. I'm Joe Van Goor. We gave you the team stats for Yankton. Individually, Yankton is led in scoring by Ellie Karlovitz at 13.5 points per game. Claire Tereshinsky off the bench has 8 points a game after 2 games, and Jordan Salvatore averaging 7 points after 2 games. Ellie Karlovitz leads the Gazelles in rebounding at 6.5 boards a game. Kate Beeman at 5.5 and Jordan Salvatore at 5 even. On defense, Ellie Karlovitz leads in steals with 5, and she has the only block shot for the Gazelles with 1 on the season. Claire Tereshinsky and Molly Savvy each have 2 three-pointers to lead the Gazelles so far this season. So let's bring you tonight's starting lineups as we have a rather extensive introduction here. For Sioux Falls, Washington, at a forward, Jackulenga Wentantata, a 6'2 senior. A second forward, Hannah Harp, a 6' junior. A third forward is Brooklyn Harp, a 6' junior. Along with Wentantata going to Texas, Harp is a junior, is getting some college looks. Taylor Thompson is the fourth forward, a 6' junior. And Alexis Motley, a 5'8 junior, is the lone guard in the starting five for Sioux Falls, Washington. Expect to see Bianca Meeks, a 5'6 senior, Claire Woods, a 5'6 freshman, Kelsey Severson, a 5'6 senior, Grace Peterson, a 5'11 freshman, and Shaylin Fink, a 5'8 junior, off the bench first for Sioux Falls, Washington. For the Yankton Gazelles, at a forward, Jordan Salvatore, a 6' senior, Kate Beeman, a 5'11 senior, and the three-guard set of Jillian Eisness, a 5'5 senior, Ellie Karlovitz, a 5'10 senior, and Molly Savvy, a 5'8 senior. Expect to see Claire Tereshinsky, a 5'5 sophomore, Bailey LaCroix, a 5'6 sophomore, Macy Drotzman, a 5'9 sophomore, and Ellie Fieser, a 5'5 junior, off the bench first for the Yankton Gazelles. Washington is in their home white, trimmed out in orange and in black. The Gazelles in their road red, trimmed out in white and a little bit of black. Our officials in this evening's game, the referee is Chad Voskuhl, and the umpires are Luke Anderson and Pete Entringer. Once again, in the sub-varsity games on the Fox Stop scoreboard, Sioux Falls, Washington won the JV game 57-39. Washington won the sophomore game 62-14, and Washington defeated Yankton in the freshman game 45-19. And, of course, Michael, at the same time, the Yankton Bucks are opening up their season at home against third-ranked Sioux Falls, Washington. Those two teams split last year, but Washington has a new coach. And, of course, the Yankton Bucks starting, well, for the first time after, what, 6 years without Matthew Moores.
Yeah, that Bucks game should be an interesting one. It'll be interesting to hear who steps forward for them. Ironically, yeah, the Bucks' first game this year is now against the last team they faced last year when they became for third place in the state tournament. Yeah, but they have a new coach. They're both teams in transition and see where they are at this point. It'll be fun to hear and see what we have going on here in Sioux Falls as well.
That's right. And that game, folks, can be heard and seen on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570, KVTK.com, and also on Five Star Streaming from YouTube, the voice of the Vermilion Tanagers, Heath Nimke, helping us out with the Bucks opener against Sioux Falls, Washington, over on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570. Well, folks, we're not kidding. We have a very extended introductions here, so tell you what, let us take a 1 minute timeout and be back with more on the First Dakota Yankton Medical Clinic Gazelle Basketball pregame show back in a minute on Classic Hits 106.3.
For 75 years servicing Northeast Nebraska, Elkhorn Valley Bank and Trust has crossed the river and is excited to announce the opening of a new Yankton branch.
I'm Glenn Peterson, Market President. While Elkhorn Valley Bank might be new to Yankton, our staff has years of banking experience in the Yankton area. Our focus is on our customers and the communities in which they live. We look forward to serving you and giving back to Yankton and the surrounding communities. We invite you to come see that at Elkhorn Valley Bank, there really is a difference.
Member FDIC.
It's time for Question of the Night.
What local-owned and operated convenience store in Yankton has the best cheese from Dimmick, South Dakota, a freezer to go with the cheese filled with all the meats, and gives 5 cents off when you pay cash? That's right. It's Triple Time Rudy's, located right next to Subway. Cheeses, meats, gas, drinks, and more. It's time for Triple Time Rudy's.
All right, it's time for What's Hot and What's Not, brought to you by Larry's Heating and Cooling of Yankton and Vermilion. Larry's is your Lennox and Carrier dealer anytime, any day. Well, the Gazelles need to warm up the shooting. Again, coming into tonight's game, shooting at 30.9%. But what's hot for the Gazelles? Ellie Karlovitz, who has led the Gazelles in double figures in both games. Jordan Salvatore for Yankton. Antonenda for Washington, and Washington controls the tap, going right to left. Here's a three left corner that won't fall. Offensive rebound and a putback good by Brooklyn Harp. That corner from the left corner three was taken by Alexis Motley. Washington, with some backcourt pressure, causes a Yankton turnover, and they'll take it on the far sideline as the ball goes in to Washington. Washington with a 2-0 lead. Here's Wentanada inside, and she will score over Molly Savvy, and it's already 4-0 Washington, 30 seconds into tonight's game here on Classic Hits 106.3, KVHTRadio.com, and on 5-star streaming from YouTube. A pass by Jordan, by Kate Beeman to Jordan Salvatore gets knocked off the floor. On the near sideline, Kate Beeman will throw it in, but the Gazelles down 4-0 on the Fox Stop scoreboard. And here is a steal by Washington. Motley at the other end with the steal and the score. Motley is the third Washington starter to score, and it's 6-0 Washington. We haven't played a minute. For Yankton, Salvatore. Here left side in the corner is Savvy for a three, and it's too strong. Rebound tapped out of bounds by Washington. It'll belong to Yankton with 6:52 left to go. First quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Washington 6 and Yankton nothing. Beeman on the far sideline near the Washington bench will get it in to Ellie Karlovitz, guarded by Motley. Left side to Beeman. Beeman on the baseline with a jumper that's short. Rebound to Brooklyn Harp of Washington. Up ahead to Hannah Harp, called for traveling. She had it on the right side, moving in, and it'll be Yankton basketball. 6:39 left to go, first quarter. Sioux Falls, Washington 6, and Yankton nothing. On the far sideline, Beeman will get it into Karlovitz. Now to Beeman. Beeman across the timeline will bring it toward the middle. Given the lane to Salvatore, right baseline, jumper by Savvy is up and good. And Yankton's on the board, trailing 6-2, 6:25 left to go in the first quarter. For Washington, Harp to Harp. This is Brooklyn on the left baseline. Out front to Thompson. Thompson will set up for a three, and it's short. Battle for the rebound. It comes to Brooklyn Harp and a Yankton foul. The foul is on Jillian Eisness of the Gazelles, her first, team's first. 6-2 Washington, 6:09 left to go, first quarter. Motley on the baseline, gets it in to Jackalinga, and she stepped on the end line while getting the inbounds pass. Turnover, we'll give it to Yankton. Washington putting on a 2-1-2 full court press. It goes into Ellie Karlovitz. Karlovitz quickly across the timeline, on the left driving, and a foul on Motley. Motley with her first, team's first, Yankton will play it in on the end line underneath their own basket with a new shot clock trailing 6-2, 6:02 left to go. Here's the inbounds pass. Three from the corner, no good by Karlovitz. It goes in the lane to Beeman. Her shot partially deflected by Thompson. Here comes Brooklyn Harp. Brooklyn to Hannah to Thompson. Left corner to Motley as Yankton has switched to his own, starting man-to-man. Washington playing man-to-man defensively. A Washington jumper that's no good. Yankton with the rebound. Quickly up court. Here is Beeman from 15, and it's good. Kate Beeman makes it Yankton's trailing Washington 6-4. 5:23 left to go, first quarter. Sub at the table for Washington at the next dead ball. Here's a pass down low to Wentonata. Brooklyn Harp driving with a Euro step. The layup is good. Brooklyn Harp with a drive from the left side has four. That stops a 4-0 Yankton run. 8-4 Washington. 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. Here's Beeman out front to Eisness. Jillian. Here's a turnaround by Karlovitz that might have been deflected. Oh, they say it's Washington basketball. Washington will bring in two. Shaylin Fink, a 5'8 junior. Also in, Bianca Meeks, a 5'6 senior. Yankton will bring in Macy Drotzman, the 5'9 sophomore, and Claire Tereshinsky, the 5'5 sophomore. Here out front, Wentonata. Pass in the left corner to Fink. Fink up on the left, called for double dribble. It'll be Yankton basketball. Almost halfway through the first quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Sioux Falls, Washington 8 and Yankton 4. Washington with some backcourt pressure. It goes into Karlovitz. Here's Tereshinsky breaking the press. Jumper from beyond the free throw line. High off the rim, no good. Offensive rebound went to Salvatore, taken away by Fink. Here's Wentonata in the lane. Stopped, goes down low to Brooklyn Harp, and Brooklyn Harp has 6 points, and now a 4-0 run by Washington to lead 10-4 with 4:10 left to go, first quarter. For Yankton, Tereshinsky to Savvy. Molly stopped on the left, ball knocked away, a steal by Meeks, up ahead to Wentonata, and the layup is good. Jackalinga, Wentonata has four, now a 6-0 run by Washington, leading 12-4. 3:50 left to go, first quarter. For Yankton, Karlovitz. Inside the top of the key to Salvatore. Tereshinsky stops, has her shot blocked by Hannah Harp. Here's Brooklyn Harp to Meeks. Brooklyn Harp goes inside, and the short jumper no good. And a foul on the rebound on Ellie Karlovitz of Yankton. On Ellie, that's her first. Team second. Yankton will bring back in Eisness along with Ellie Fieser, a 5'5 junior. And let's see, somebody else came in. It goes in to Thompson, who's back in for Washington. She is fouled underneath and will shoot two with 3:29 left to go, first quarter, with the Warriors leading the Gazelles 12-4. First free throws for either team. The first of two is no good. Thompson from the free throw line against Lincoln the other night was 2 out of 4. Wentonata comes out. And the second free throw by Thompson is good. She is the fourth Washington starter to score. Now a 7-0 run by Washington to lead Yankton 13-4. 3:25 left to go, first quarter. Drotzman on the left block for Yankton. Dribbles out to Eisness. Eisness gives it to Drotzman. Macy called for traveling. So 3:13 left to go, first quarter. Warriors 13 and the Gazelles 4. Warriors on a 7-0 run. Washington will bring back in Hannah Harp, who is the only Washington starter not to have scored yet. Brooklyn Harp with 6 points will come out. So the inbounds pass goes to Alexis Motley. Motley against the Gazelle zone. Here is Hannah Harp inside to Thompson. Off the glass, no good. Gets her own rebound. and is fouled on the floor by one of the Gazelles. Foul is on Kate Beeman. That is her first, team's third. Check that fourth team foul. On the end line, Motley will get it out front. Ball knocked away by Karlovitz. Kelsey Severson, a 5'6 senior who's in, will go into the backcourt to retrieve it. It goes to Moxley out front. Right side, Hannah Harp. Hannah driving to the lane, and the runner no good. Rebound, Ellie Karlovitz for Yankton. 13-4 Washington, still on a 7-0 run. And here's a Washington foul on Hannah Harp. On Hannah Harp, that's her second, team second.
Personal foul, number 33, Hannah Harp.
Coming out is Grace Peterson, a 5'11 freshman who snuck in when we weren't looking for Washington. Yankton plays it in on the near sideline. Here's Karlovitz over to Savvy. A three on the way is short. Rebound to Thompson as she outfought Salvatore. Went to Nada back in to Hannah Harp. Here is Moxley. She'll get a return pass on the right baseline. And here is Thompson. No, that was Motley with a great move on the baseline. She has four. 15-4, 9-0 run. Tereshinsky for three, left side, no good. And the ball off the floor, it'll belong to Yankton. So we've been going without a break, really, in this first quarter. Washington will bring back in Shaylin Fink, and coming out, Taylor Thompson, who has a free throw. Inbounds pass knocked away by Alexis Motley on the end line. Molly Savvy to throw it in. Savvy from the near sideline will get it into Beeman. Here's Karlovitz. Karlovitz driving, lost the ball to Fink. Back the other way, Hannah Harp. Went to Nada. Motley to Fink. Back to Motley. Motley on the high post. Jackulenga with a three, no good. Rebound to Fink. She'll put it back up and in. First bench points for either team, and Yankton will take a full timeout. 1:33 left to go. In the first quarter, 11-0 run by Sioux Falls, Washington. They lead Yankton 17-4 on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Time for a Culligan water break. Culligan Water of Yankton, think outside the bottle at 401 East 4th Street, Yankton. Back in a minute on Classic Hits 106.3.
Schaefer Plumbing. Honest, fair, and friendly. When it comes to plumbing, you often don't think much about it until something goes horribly wrong. The name to remember is Schaefer Plumbing. Or maybe you're looking to upgrade. A remodel is something that would make your bathroom or kitchen more enjoyable. The name to remember is Schaefer Plumbing. And here's something you may not know. Schaefer Plumbing installs lawn irrigation systems. You know what I'm going to say next, right? The name to remember is Schaefer Plumbing. Schaefer Plumbing. Honest, fair, and friendly.
Don't let the name fool you. Rexall Drug isn't just a drugstore. I mean, yes, it is a drugstore that can help with your pharmacy needs, but it also has more. Hallmark gift cards and ornaments, because Christmas is coming up sooner than you think. And many more gifts to select from throughout the store, including a kids section. But my favorite is the selection of chocolates at the front. It's not just a drugstore, it's Yankton Rexall.
careers.com.
So after a full timeout by Yankton, Washington playing a zone. Here's a baseline jumper, no good by Salvatore, but she is fouled, I believe, by Hannah Harp of Washington. And it is. Hannah Harp will pick up her second, team's third. At the line, Jordan Salvatore, first time the Gazelles have been to the line. Salvatore is 3 of 6 from the line coming in. First of two, good. She is the third Yankton starter to score. Back in for Washington, Grace Peterson. And coming out, Hannah Harp, who has a couple of fouls in the game and no points. He is the only Washington starter not to have scored yet. Salvatore will get them both. Those two free throws break an 11-0 run by Washington. Washington leads 17-6. 1:12 left to go in the first quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Fink out front to Motley. Motley here right corner is Brooklyn Harp, who's back in. Down low, out front, went to Nada for a three, and it's good. 7 points for Jakulenga Wentanata on the season. She now has 2 threes, and it's 20-6 Washington. 45 seconds left to go in the first quarter. Beeman for Yankton in the lane. We'll turn and shoot, and it's no good. Wentanata with the rebound for Washington. She'll head up court. Left side, Motley, a set up three. Good. Alexis Motley with her first three of the game. Motley with her second three of the season. And now 23-6 Washington with 19 seconds left to go in the quarter. Shot clock is off. Gazelles need a hoop. Here is Karlovitz driving in. Layup no good. Wentanata with 10 seconds will bring it into the front court for Washington. Drives in. The layup no good. Rebound. Battle for it is Savvy. And that is how the first quarter will end. After one quarter, Sioux Falls, Washington, 23, Yankton, 6 on the Fox Stop scoreboard. A one-minute Culligan water break on Classic Hits 106.3.
Tom Stoltz on behalf of all the doctors and staff at our first chiropractic centers. In 1982, I started the practice. In 1993, Drs. Jim and Sheila Fitzgerald joined. In 2005, Dr. T.J. Stoltz joined us. And since then, Dr. Matt and Mackenzie Erlinson and Dr. J. Fitzgerald have joined our practices. First Chiropractic Centers, whole health with hands-on healing, with offices in Yankton, Scotland, Hardington, Wagner, and Tyndall.
Hey, this is Jack out of Jodine's, and you need to pick up your new calendar. We've actually added some new items to our $4 dinners to go. Check it out. Don't forget, we'll do the cooking for you. 2809 Broadway, Jodine's, Yankton. This is Jack out of Jodine's, and we have the buffet open, and that is every day of the week. Monday through Saturday, it starts at 11. Sunday, it starts at 10:30. So come on out and partake in the regular buffet. 2809 Broadway, Yankton.
Well, after one quarter, Michael, Sioux Falls, Washington, 23, Yankton, 6.
Yeah, it's been a pretty dominant performance by Sioux Falls, Washington. A lot of their starters have been involved, the bench. And their star is everything she's cracked up to be, that's for sure. So Yankton needs to kind of get it right. Ellie hasn't seemed to flip that switch yet, so hopefully she can get that going here in the second quarter.
All right, Yankton basketball to start the second quarter. Beeman gets it in to Jillian Eisness. On the high post, Beeman will turn and shoot, but it won't fall. And here's a foul on the rebound on Washington, and I believe Jakulenga Wentanata will be guilty of the foul, and it will. That is her first, team's fourth. Here is Beeman driving the lane after the inbounds pass and gets a nice roll. Kate Beeman has 4. 23-8 Washington, just starting the second quarter. 20 seconds gone. Here's Wentanata. Over to Bianca Meeks. Right side to Kelsey Severson. Wentanata, left side, an open three for Meeks, and it's no good. Battle for the rebound, and it's off the floor off Wentanata. It'll belong to Yankton. Yankton trailed 6-4 in the first quarter. Washington went on an 11-0 run before the Gazelles scored again on a couple Jordan Salvatore free throws. Washington by 15. The Gazelles with the basketball. Here's Ellie Fieser on the left. Ellie looking for help. Goes to Savvy. Savvy double-teamed. Goes back to Fieser. Fieser toward the middle. In the lane. Down low to Beeman. Stripped of the ball but was fouled and will shoot two with 7 minutes to go in the first half. The foul is on Kelsey Severson, her first, team's fifth. Kate Beeman at the line. is 1 out of 2 so far this season and has 4 points to lead the Gazelles. First of two is good. Back in for Yankton, Ellie Karlovitz and Macy Drotzman. Jordan Salvatore with a couple free throws, and Molly Savvy, who has a bucket, will come out for Yankton. 7 minutes to go first half on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Warriors 23, Yankton now 10, as Beeman will get them both. Back the other way, Severson for three right side, airmails it. It's off the floor, last touch by Washington's Bianca Meeks. Back in for Washington is Hannah Harp and Alexis Motley. Wentanada goes out, and so does Grace Peterson. Again, Washington with full court pressure. It goes into Jillian Eisness. Eisness over to Tereshinsky, across the timeline to Beeman, to Karlovitz. Quick jumper in the lane, doesn't find it. Offensive rebound to Drotzman, had her shot blocked, taken by Karlovitz. Karlovitz inside is fouled by Taylor Thompson and will go to the line for two more with 6:37 left to go in the half. So Taylor Thompson with her first, team sixth. Ellie Karlovitz hasn't scored yet at the line for a pair. Ellie, 4 of 11 on free throws, first of two good. Gazelles are shooting free throws well, Michael, and back in for Washington is Brooklyn Harp.
Yeah, free throws have been an issue this year so far.
Yes, they have. 23 to 11, and Ellie missed the second. Ball knocked off the floor, last touch by Taylor Thompson of the Warriors. 6:36 left to go first half on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Sioux Falls, Washington 23, Yankton 11. Inbounds pass, Tereshinsky, quick three, good! Claire Tereshinsky with the first three of the game for Yankton. On the season, that's her third. And it's 23-13. Gazelles battling back from a kind of a deep deficit. Here is Hannah Harp down low, though. Off the right block, she'll score off the glass, and Washington will get a steal. All five Washington starters have scored now. Here's a pass down low to Moxley. Puts up a shot, no good. Off the floor, last touch by Bianca Meeks of Washington. 25-13. The biggest lead for Washington when it was 23-8. Meeks will come out for Washington. And back in is Brooklyn Harp for the Gazelles. Here is Tereshinsky to Eisness, to Beeman. High post to Karlovitz. Turns and shoots, and it's no good. Wentanada back in with the rebound. Up court, driving the lane, and the layup, no good. And a tie-up on the rebound. It'll go back to Sioux Falls, Washington. Jordan Salvatore and Molly Savvy will check back in for Yankton. And coming out, Eisness and Beeman. Eisness is the only Yankton starter not to have scored yet. Beeman with 6 points to lead the Gazelles. Inbounds pass to Brooklyn Harp, to Thompson. Out front, Hannah Harp. Hannah moving in from the left. The layup is short, but a foul before that on Yankton. And it's on Ellie Karlovitz. That's her second, 15 foul. Ellie will have to come out with only a point. Ellie Fieser back in for Yankton. 25-13 Washington. It goes into Thompson on the block to Wentanada. Here is Hannah Harp for a three, short. Battle for the rebound. It'll come to Brooklyn Harp. She missed a shot underneath the basket. It goes to Motley. She'll put it up and in. Alexis Motley has 9 of Washington's 27 points. 27-13 Washington with 5:15 left to go first half. Tereshinsky driving in is fouled with 5:12 left in the half. And that should be a 1-1 for Yankton. Motley with her second personal, 17 foul. Claire Tereshinsky shooting in the 1-1. Coming back in for Washington, Grace Peterson. And coming out Hannah Harp. Tereshinsky on the season. First free throw attempt of the season. Missed the front end of the 1-1. Went to Nada with the rebound for Washington. Brings it up court. Stops at the free throw line. Long three by Thompson is off the back of the rim. No good. Offensive rebound to Motley. Motley down low to Wentanada, and with the left hand, she'll score. She has nine. 29-13, now the biggest lead for Washington. 4:51 left to go, first half. And this after Yankton fought back from a 15-point deficit. Here is a steal by Motley, and the layup is good. She is the first in double figures for either team. 31-13, Washington by 18. 4:33 left in the half. Salvatore driving, no good. Rebound to Thompson. Back the other way, Alexis Motley. Motley gets a return pass on the right. Gets it out front to Wentanada. To Brooklyn Harp. Wentanada, long three, good. And Wentanada is in double figures as she has 12, a full timeout for Yankton. 4:14 left in the half. On the Fox Stop scoreboard, Sioux Falls, Washington, 34, and Yankton, 13, a 60-second Culligan water break on Classic Hits, 106.3.
Ryzen Healthcare in Yankton offers medical, dental, and behavioral health services for all, from tooth pains to aches and pains. Our new location on 920 Broadway Avenue is a comfortable, expanded space where everyone is welcome. Whether insured, uninsured, Medicaid, or Medicare, here in Yankton, we care for all. And that's what we care about most. Call to schedule your appointment at Horizon Healthcare.
What if there was someone to make sure they were protected? What if there was someone to help your future be clear? What if there was someone to help during the tough news? From vision to cancer and all things in between, that someone is Nick Antrobus. The Antrobus Agency, making your benefits count for today.
So Yankton uses their second full timeout and down by 21 to Washington, 34-13 on the Fox Stop scoreboard halfway through the second quarter. For Yankton, Tereshinsky to Karlovitz. Ellie driving and had her shot blocked from behind by Hannah Harp, dug out by Fink, but Fink loses the basketball while trying to get control of it. It'll belong to Yankton on the far sideline in front of the Washington bench, near coach Jamie Parrish. Ellie Fieser to throw it in for Yankton. Fieser will get it in to Karlovitz. Karlovitz starting a drive on the left side, called for traveling. So 3:48 left in the half. Washington has held the Gazelles to 7 points while scoring 11 themselves. And here's a three right side by Hannah Harp. Hannah Harp with her first three, 5 points in the quarter. For Hannah Harp, that's her second three of the season, 37-13. Washington running away and hiding here in the second quarter with 3:24 left in the half. A pass down low for Yankton gets knocked off the floor by the Warriors. It'll be Yankton basketball. Wentanada will come out on the end line. Ellie Fieser to throw it in. And here's a steal by Brooklyn Harp. Up ahead to Hannah Harp. Inside, easy layup for two for Claire Woods, a 5'6 freshman, seeing her first action of the game. Second bucket off the Washington bench, 39-13 Washington. 3:05 left to go, first half. For Yankton, Tereshinsky. Washington playing zone. Both teams started man, but both are playing zone. Down low, Karlovitz gets bumped on the left block by Fink. Missed the shot, no foul called. Back the other way, Brooklyn Harp will score again. She has eight. And it's a landslide for Washington here in the second quarter, leading the Gazelles 41-13, 2:39 left in the half. Here is Karlovitz on the baseline with an air ball off the floor. Last touch by Ellie Fieser of Yankton. Jordan Salvatore and Molly Savvy back in for Yankton. Back in for Washington, Bianca Meeks. And also back in, Kelsey Severson. 41-13. Washington over Yankton, 2:29 left in the half on the Fox Stop scoreboard. For Washington, Severson out front to Fink. Left side, Brooklyn Harp. Brooklyn stops her dribble. Gives to Claire Woods. Woods inside to Fink. Missed the shot off the glass. And the rebound to Salvatore for Yankton. Here comes Claire Tereshinsky with 2:05 left in the half. Salvatore inside. Missed a shot too hard off the glass. Rebound to Fink. Up ahead, Brooklyn Harp. Three left side by Bianca Meeks. No good. Offensive rebound and a putback no good by Claire Woods of Washington. Yankton the other way. Here's Ellie Karlovitz. And a steal by Meeks. Meeks has Beeman to beat, but goes over to Brooklyn Harp, who will score easily. She is the third Washington starter in double figures with 10. 43-13. Yankton hasn't scored in a great while. 1:27 left to go first half. Tereshinsky trying to keep control of the ball, loses it, but Karlovitz picks it up. Karlovitz tried to go down low, ball knocked away. Here's Brooklyn Harp. Up ahead to Bianca Meeks, to Fink. Fink on the drive, the layup good. Shaylin Fink with four. 45-13 Washington with 1 minute to go in the first half on the Fox Stop scoreboard. And all that Trey Creer and his coaching staff can do is watch. Three by Karlovitz, no good. Offensive rebound, Beeman drives in, missed it. Here's Salvatore with a rebound and a putback. The Gazelles' first basket in a while, 45-15 Washington. 40 seconds to go in the half. A pass down low, knocked off the floor. It'll belong to Washington. Yankton will bring in Peyton Mosier, a 5'5 sophomore. And I believe Jillian Eisness checked back in as well. Washington on the end line. It goes inside to Grace Peterson. She is fouled and will shoot a pair with 35.1 left to go in the half. The foul on Peyton Mosier, her first, team's sixth. So Grace Peterson, first free throw attempt of the season, and she hits it to make it 46-15 Washington. 35.1 left in the half. Second free throw no good. Rebound to Eisness for Yankton. Ellie will shovel it to Ellie Fieser. Up ahead to Eisness. Jillian stays on the left. Gives it to Macy Drotzman, who's back in. And now an offensive foul called on Macy. Her first, team seventh, since it was a player control foul on Yankton. No 1-1 for Washington. 20.7 left in the half. Washington from the far sideline gets it in to Claire Woods. A dominating second quarter indeed by Washington. It goes inside, and a short jumper by Grace Peterson. Good. Her first field goal. She has 3 points. 48-15. 4 seconds to go. Savvy loses the ball. Picked up by Drotzman. It goes to Fieser driving. The layup is good, but it's waved off. And at halftime, it's Sioux Falls, Washington 48, Yankton 15. We'll be back with the Joe Deans halftime show coming up. Joe Deans, the South Dakota tradition, North Broadway, Yankton, home of the $4 dinners to go every day. Chicken, catfish, walleye, and shrimp. Grab a calendar of the month for more $4 dinners to go. Seafood buffet every Friday and Saturday night. Sunday breakfast buffet starting at 10:30 a.m. Call Jodine 665-9884 for your to-go order. Let's take a two-minute Culligan water break on Classic Hits 106.3.
JR's Oasis in Yankton, your one-stop store for everything you need. The parking lot, it's the biggest in town for ease of getting in and out. Oh, and the selection they have inside, it's unbeatable. Energy drinks, coffee, pop, and even something for the adults. Now the food selection, they only give me 30 seconds, but there's daily specials posted right on the outside, along with burgers, ribs, and so much more. JR's Oasis, Highway 50 East, Yankton.
Cornerstone Jewelry Design in Yankton's Meridian District is your local fine jewelry destination. We offer unique jewelry for every budget. Rings, earrings, necklaces, and bracelets, plus Landstrom's Black Hills Gold and our brand new selection of Seiko watches. Or we can custom design your perfect piece. We provide cleaning, inspection, and repairs, everything you need in a jewelry store, with the local values and service you love. For your milestones, count on Cornerstone. Stop and see us on 3rd Street or visit cornerstonejewelry.com.
Balanced. Avera.
All season.
Most new systems today, it's important to remember to maintain the warranty. You need to show proof of service. Things that you can expect from Larry's Heating and Cooling Comfort Care Club are prompt, timely service, 2 maintenances, and respect. If you ever have an issue, from Lennox to Carrier and everything in between, we're there for you. For any inquiries about our pricing, feel free to call us at 1-800-491-9461. Anytime, any day.
Insurance can be complicated, but it doesn't have to be when you insure with Midwest Insurance Agency, located at 3016 Piper Street. Through 3 generations, Midwest Insurance Agency has numerous awards and has spent many hours serving the community. Travis and Whitney Devine carry on that family legacy. Whether it's the family farm or a vehicle, make sure it's protected. Midwest Insurance at the corner of Piper Street and 31st. Stop or call for your quote today.
Back at the gym at Sioux Falls Washington High School, along with our studio engineer, Casey Miners, our Yankton Sportscaster Club members with Michael Schumacher, Joe Van Goor. At the half, defending AA girls champion and top-ranked Sioux Falls Washington, a commanding 48-15 lead at the half. After one quarter, Washington led 23-6. Washington in that first quarter, after the Gazelles closed to within 6-4, went on an 11-0 run before Yankton scored again. So 23-6 at the half and 48-15 at the half, or 23-6 after one quarter, 48-15 at the half. Here's your first half scoring summary for Sioux Falls, Washington. All 5 starters have scored, 3 off the bench, 3 in double figures, led by Jack Yolengo, Wentonada with 12 points, Alexis Motley with 11, Brooklyn Harp with 10, Hannah Harp with 5, and Taylor Thompson with 1. Off the bench, Shailene Fink had 4, Grace Peterson with 3, Claire Woods with 2, Bianca Meeks played but didn't score, and Kelsey Severson played in the first half for Washington but didn't score. Washington, 21 field goals, 4 of those 3-pointers, 1 by Wentonada, 1 by Harp, 1 by Motley, no, actually 2 by Wentonada, 1 by Hannah Harp, and 1 by Alexis Motley. Washington, 2 out of 4 from the free throw line at the half. For Yankton, 4 out of their 5 starters have scored, 1 off the bench. Kate Beeman with 6 points, Jordan Salvatore with 4, Molly Savvy with 2, and Ellie Karlovitz with only a point among the starters. Jillian Eisness started but didn't score. And Claire Tereshinsky with a 3-pointer off the bench. We'll have to check that to make sure. Macy Drotzman, Ellie Fieser, and Peyton Mosier all played for Yankton off the bench but didn't score. Yankton, 5 field goals, 1 of those a 3-pointer by Tereshinsky. And Yankton, 5 out of 7 from the free throw line at the half. Washington leads at the half, 48-15, on the Jodine's Halftime Show on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Let's take a 1-minute timeout. When we come back, Beyond the Game, checking fine arts at the Yankton Public Schools, back in a minute on Classic Hits 106.3.
New year, new flooring. I plan on saying hello with new flooring from Larson Carpet in Yankton. Larson Carpet will help with design and installation. They have a great selection of carpet, vinyl, luxury vinyl plank, hardwood, and tile. Stop in and let them help you get a new look in the new year. Larson Carpet at 208 Walnut Street in the Meridian District in Yankton. For the best flooring for your space, lifestyle, and budget, see Larson Carpet.
From simple sniffles to complex health conditions, the primary care providers at Yankton Medical Clinic will not only see you for your annual visits, screenings, and preventative care, but also provides care for the entire family, from pediatrics to adults. With 4 clinic locations and 15 outreach locations throughout South Dakota and Nebraska, compassionate, quality medical care is closer than you think. For more information on providers, services, and locations, visit our website, yanktonmedicalclinic.com.
At halftime on the Jodine's Halftime Show, Sioux Falls, Washington 48, Yankton 15. It's time for Beyond the Game, brought to you by the Riverfront Event Center, downtown Yankton. Love, live, eat, stay, and have fun at the Riverfront Event Center. For fine arts in the Yankton Public Schools, Thursday, a high school and middle school combined holiday choir concert in the main theater. And don't forget the high school choir cookie walk before and after the concert. On Thursday, Saturday, high school dance team will have a day camp at the middle school North Gym for grades K through 8. Registration starts at 8:15 in the morning on Saturday. And then Monday, the high school band holiday concert, 7 o'clock at the main theater. And that is Beyond the Game, brought to you by the Riverfront Event Center, downtown Yankton. Back after 1 minute with the Fox Stop scoreboard on Classic Hits 106.3.
Angel Crossing in Yankton, you can find kids' clothes infant to 14 for the boys and girls. There's Under Armour, Ruffle Butts, and other great brand names at the store. You can find Melissa and Duck Toys, specialty toys. Ladies, Linda can dress you too. Jeans, tops, and sweaters by Tribal Jag, Charlie Page, and Charlie B. Casual to business wear. All at Linda's Angel Crossing, 1101 Broadway in Yankton. Open Monday through Saturday, 10 to 6.
Dr. Pyle at the Veterinary Medical Clinic is dedicated to keeping your pet safe, happy, and healthy. Whether your pet needs a checkup, grooming, surgery, or a safe place to stay while you are out of town, Dr. Pyle and his staff are trained to handle your pet care needs. Dr. Pyle and his staff are proud supporters of Bucks and Gazelles academics and athletics. Veterinary Medical Clinic is ready to serve all of your pet care needs. Veterinary Medical Clinic, 1603 Broadway, Yankton, 665-9441.
The entire family.
Time for the Fox Stop scoreboard. The Fox Stop, located on the corner of West City Limits Road and 31st Street, open 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily, a full-service convenience store with gas, diesel, food, munchies, beverages, the cellar, and the video lottery room. In other AA girls action, start of the second quarter, Watertown 9, Mitchell 2. At halftime, Brandon Valley 27, Sioux Falls Jefferson 19. Other games scheduled, Sioux Falls Roosevelt and O'Gorman, Brookings and Huron and Belle Fouche and Sturgis Brown. Let's check and see how the Bucks are doing. At halftime, the Bucks lead Sioux Falls Washington 34-18. Again, that game with Heath Dimke on ESPN 101.5, AM 1570, online at kvtk.com, and on five-star streaming from YouTube. In other AA boys games, Belle Fouche leads Sturgis 41-24 fourth quarter. At halftime in boys AA action, Brookings 29, Huron 20. At halftime, Mitchell 30, Watertown 27, Harrisburg leads Sioux Falls Lincoln 41-31 at halftime. Other games, but no scores, Sioux Falls Roosevelt and O'Gorman, Rapid City Stevens and Rapid City Central, and Douglas at St. Thomas More, as here we're about to start period number 3. And that is halftime, brought to you by Jodine's, the South Dakota tradition, North Broadway, Yankton, home of the $4 dinners to go every day, chicken, catfish, walleye, and shrimp. Grab a calendar of the month for more $4 dinners to go. Seafood Buffet every Friday and Saturday night. Sunday Breakfast Buffet starting at 10:30 a.m. Call Jodine 665-9884 for your to-go order. Washington will start with the basketball here in the third quarter. Jack Yalenga, Wentanada, Hannah Harp, Brooken Harp, Taylor Thompson, and Alexis Motley will set the Yankton lineup. Here's a three from the left side by Brooklyn Harp. That's good. Brooklyn Harp with 13, her first three of the game. Brooklyn, her second of the season. And Washington leads 51-15. Both teams playing zone to start the second half. Both teams played man, but both teams switched to a zone defensively in the first quarter. For Yankton, the same way they started, Jordan Salvatore, Kate Beeman, Jillian Eisness, Ellie Karlovitz, and Molly Savvy. Here is Karlovitz. Karlovitz backs up. A three on the way is short, out of bounds. It'll go to Sioux Falls, Washington. So, Michael, an impressive first half by the Bucks down in Yankton.
Yeah. I thought Washington was going to be a tough test for them, so that might be a really good sign for the season for the Bucks. I'd like to see the score distribution from that one.
Here is a three out front by Motley. That's good. Her second three of the game. She has 14. And Washington pouring it on. 54-14 Warriors with 7 minutes left to go in the third quarter. For Yankton, deflected pass by Beeman into the hands of Salvatore inside. Her shot up, blocked, and a putback up and good by Karlovitz. Karlovitz with her first field goal. 54-17 Washington. Three right side, no good by Hannah Harp. Rebound to Beeman. Beeman will bring it up the floor. You and I will see the Bucks at Lincoln on Friday night. That'll be a test. Lincoln's got a good couple good perimeter players and a seven-footer inside.
Yeah, that seven-footer is going to be a tough test for our height-challenged team.
Ellie Karlovitz driving in. Had a shot blocked. Molly Savvy missed a shot while we were yakking about the Bucks. Here at the other end, Alexis Motley will score again. She has 16, 56-17. Sioux Falls, Washington over Yankton with 6 minutes to go, third quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Molly Savvy, baseline jumper off the back of the rim, no good. Ellie Karlovitz hits the floor again, and it's a foul on Washington. And it's on Wentanada. That is her second, team's first this half. Tara Shinsky is back in. All right. Now I know why the correction. I gave her a three in the first half. It was only a two. Claire with a jumper on the high post on the left, up and good. So she has four instead of five like she should. And it's 56-19. Sioux Falls, Washington. Down low. Here is Thompson. Up and no good. Rebound tipped into the hands of Kate Beeman. Here's Molly Savvy into the front court to Karlovitz. Out front to Beeman. Here's Tereshinsky driving in. Tereshinsky reverse layup blocked by Taylor Thompson. And it's off Tereshinsky out of bounds to Sioux Falls, Washington. Ellie Fieser back in for Yankton. Ellie Karlovitz, who, well, the last time the Gazelles had the ball hit the floor, the time before hit the floor and might have bumped the back of her head. Thompson inside to Brooklyn Harp, and Claire Tereshinsky jumped all over her back. No, they give it to Salvatore. That's her first, team's first. Washington plays it in. It goes to Thompson. Lean in is no good. Rebound to Beeman. Rebound foul on Washington. Bianca Meeks is back in for Washington. Commits the foul, her first, team second. In for Washington is Keely Strom, a 5'4 sophomore. Her first action of the game. 5 minutes to go, third quarter. Washington 56, Yankton 19 on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Here's Tereshinsky to Salvatore. Salvatore to Beeman, right through her hands, taken by Strom. Strom, and a layup no good by Meeks. Offensive rebound by Washington, and a putback no good, and the rebound to Yankton. Here's Ellie Fieser. Fieser across the timeline, stopped. Right corner three by Savvy, too strong. And the rebound to Hannah Harp. Harp driving it. Here's Meeks on the little runner. No good. Gets her own rebound. A three. No good by Severson, who's back in for Washington. We're almost halfway through the third. Washington gets a steal. And driving in, Keely Strom. She is fouled and will shoot two with 4:17 left in the third. Jordan Salvatore with her second team foul for Washington. Keely Strom, first free throw attempt of the season, shooting two. First of two is good. Substitutions for both teams, and now a timeout wanted by Yankton. Yankton will take their third timeout. It's only a 30, so we'll keep it here. They have a full and a 30 as Sioux Falls, Washington hasn't had to take a timeout yet. So again, Yankton will be at Sioux Falls Lincoln in boys basketball Friday night here on Classic Hits 106.3, KVHTRadio.com, and on 5-star streaming from YouTube. Michael and I will have the Buck basketball pregame show at 6:45, tip-off at 7. Strom has already made one. She missed the second. And a foul on the rebound on Ava Brink, a 6'1 sophomore who has checked in for Washington. That's her first, team's third. Nope, sorry, lane violation on Yankton. And this time, Keely Strom will hit the free throw. So the Warriors lead 58-19, almost halfway through the third quarter for Yankton. Here's Karlovitz. Tereshinsky, a quick three. Good. This time it's a three. She has 5 of her 7 points in this quarter. 58-22, Washington. 3:56 left in the third on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Washington has Bailey Lester in, a 5'8 senior, so everybody that's dressing varsity for Washington is getting to play tonight. Here down low is Ava Brink. Up and good. Ava Brink off the bench with a bucket. 60-22. Washington over Yankton, 3:33. Here's Eisness, right side to Fieser for the Gazelles. Fieser will get it out front. And now Yankton loses the ball. Here comes Keely Strom. Strom to Meeks. Three, right side. Good by Washington's Kelsey Severson. Severson with her first three of the season, 63-22. Here is a three left corner by Fieser, no good. Put back by Drotzman, was partially deflected from behind by Bailey Lester. Washington with under 3 minutes to go in the third. Here's a three left side that's too strong for Kelsey Severson, and Yankton with the rebound up ahead. Here on the right is Eisness. Eisness driving in. We'll go to Tereshinsky. Now to Karlovitz. Karlovitz, Macy Drotzman. And a pass to Ellie Fieser goes into the backcourt and out of bounds. Washington will play it in on the end line. Yankton will bring back in Beeman, Salvatore, and Savvy. Coming out, Karlovitz, Drotzman, and Tereshinsky. 2:23 left in the third. 63-22 Washington over Yankton on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Pass inside, stolen away by Salvatore. That pass intended for Ava Brink. Back the other way comes Yankton, trailing 63-22. Here inside is Salvatore. Salvatore jumper, no good. Rebound tap to Eisness. Eisness lost it. Washington saves it for Salvatore. Gazelles have it out front with a new shot clock, but they throw it away. Nope. Deflected off the floor. Thought that Molly Savvy at last touched it, but she didn't. Peyton Mosier back in for Yankton. And Ellie Fieser will come out. Peyton didn't dress against Sioux Falls Lincoln about a week and a half ago in the opener. But she played in the first half. Now she's playing here in the second half. Here's Eisness. Eisness will throw to the Gazelle on the bench. Well, she was open, but she was out of bounds. 63-22. Sioux Falls, Washington over Yankton. 1:46 left to go in the third quarter on the Fox Stop scoreboard. And here is a foul on Washington. I believe Bailey Lester set an illegal screen. Yep, that's her first. Team's third. 99 seconds left to go, third quarter. Sioux Falls, Washington leads 63-22. Here's Savvy. Left baseline jumper short. Rebound knocked off the floor by Ava Brink, who has a bucket in the game off the bench this quarter. Yankton basketball. Savvy gets it into Eisness. Left side of the lane to Beeman, knocked away, taken by Peyton Mosier. Left corner, Eisness. Eisness will throw it away. Pass intended for Mosier, intercepted by Kelsey Severson. 63-22 Washington. 1:12. Here's a steal by Eisness. Doesn't have numbers, will slow up. Now will drive the lane. Gets a down low to Salvatore on the right baseline. Short shot by Beeman, no good. Rebound by Salvatore, up and in. Jordan Salvatore with six. Claire Tereshinsky leads the Gazelles with seven off the bench. 63-24 with 45 seconds left to go in the quarter. Bianca Meeks for Washington out front against Peyton Mosier of Yankton. On the high post to Brink. Left side to Kelsey Severson. Here's a three on the way. Good by Bianca Meeks. Meeks with her first bucket of the game and her second three of the season. 66-24 Washington. 20 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Shot clock is off. Here is Savvy in traffic. Her jumper blocked. And Washington, thinking that there was not much time on the clock, I believe that was Meeks. She's the one that's holding her hand to her mouth and a little embarrassed at shooting with 10 seconds left in the half or in the quarter. Now Yankton with 5 seconds. Here is Eisness off the glass, no good. Rebound to Washington. And after three quarters, Sioux Falls, Washington 66, Yankton 24. On the Fox Stop scoreboard, let's take a 60-second Culligan water break on Classic Hits 106.3.
Hi, Piper Flower.
I chose Mount Marty because of the sense of community I felt ever since I first stepped on campus. I've been prepared for my career in nursing through the hands-on experience I get through classes and getting to start clinicals in my sophomore year. Here at MMU, there are countless things for you to do, whether you're on the sports team, in the theater program, or just hanging out with friends. When the weather's nice, my friends and I like to go out to the lake and go swimming, play some beach volleyball, or just hang out.
Sign Tech on East Highway 50 is your full-service sign shop. Dave of Sign Tech handles sales, service, and installation of signs of all kinds, from magnets, banners, truck and vinyl lettering, digital printing, full-color decals, and more. You can also rent a portable LED sign. Call Dave at 605-665-2957. Sign Tech is a proud sponsor of Yankton Bucks and Gazelles Athletics.
All right, heading into the fourth and final quarter. Sioux Falls, Washington 66, Yankton 24, Yankton basketball. Ellie Karlovitz back in. Here's Beeman in the lane. Beeman short shot, short. And the rebound to Washington's Ava Brink. So Yankton, with the exception of Claire Tereshinsky and Ellie Fieser, has three of their starting five back in. For Washington, Claire Woods, Washington, throwing it around the Yankton zone. Here is Shaylin Fink, who has 4 points off the bench. Here is Keely Strom driving in. Little runner, no good. Rebound, Jordan Salvatore. So let's set the Yankton lineup. Kate Beeman, Claire Tereshinsky, Ellie Fieser, Jordan Salvatore, Ellie Fieser, who has led the Gazelles in double figures first two games. She only has three tonight. Here's Fieser. Tereshinsky with a three, no good. Salvatore had a hand on the rebound, but it's taken away by Shaylin Fink. Here's a pass down low, and a shot up no good by Grace Peterson. She was fouled and will shoot two with 6:47 to go on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Washington leading 66-24. Ellie Karlovitz with her third, and the third team foul on Yankton. First of two for Grace Peterson, no good. She's now one out of three from the line. Yankton will bring back in Salvatore and take out Beeman. Washington takes out Ava Brink, who scored. And trying to see who came back in for the Warriors. Second free throw by Peterson, no good. And it's 67-24. Gazelles just succumbed to the pressure with a lot of turnovers in a stretch in the second quarter where they didn't score and Washington scored a lot. Here is Karlovitz down low to Salvatore, but stolen away by Kelsey Severson. Up ahead to Fink. Right side. Now to the left side to Kelsey Severson. Severson in the corner. Here's a drive and a layup good by Grace Peterson. She has three this quarter and six in the game, 69-24 for Yankton. Tereshinsky, runner in the lane, missed everything. Rebound to Drotzman, scores and was fouled and will go to the line to try to complete the old-fashioned three-point play. The foul is on Shaylin Fink. That's her first, team's fourth. Macy Drotzman is 2 of 2 from the line coming in. Molly Savvy will check back in for Yankton. Washington made a couple changes. Ellie Fieser, who hasn't scored, will come out. This is the first free throw since the second quarter for Yankton when Claire Tereshinsky missed the front end of a 1-1. And the free throw for Macy will get a nice, well, visitor's roll and go in. A three-point play for Macy. 69-27 Washington, 5:50 to go. For Washington, reserve mostly playing this one out. Pass inside to Ava Brink, who's back in all of a sudden. Is knocked away, taken by Yankton. Savvy into the front court. Savvy stops her dribble, gives to Claire Tereshinsky. Now Claire from the left to the middle. Shot from the free throw line, good. Claire Tereshinsky, and Yankton will take a 30-second timeout. Claire Tereshinsky edging double figures with nine. The Gazelles down to one full timeout left with 5:25 left in the go. I'm sorry, Michael, the action has been pretty hot and heavy. 69-29, Washington okay. Over Yankton.
No, that's okay. It's been back and forth. There has been a lot of action. Unfortunately, most of the action has been on the Washington basket for the Gazelles, but it's been an entertaining game.
Yankton leads Sioux Falls, Washington, in boys action in Yankton 48-30 with a minute to go in the third on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Here we're pert near done. 5:25 to go after the Yankton timeout. Washington basketball. Kelsey Severson to Bailey Lester. Lester will go left side to Bianca Meeks. Meeks to the middle. down low to Severson. Lost it out of bounds. Well, saved it from going out of bounds on the end line, but then tried to save it toward the Washington bench, and nobody was home. Yankton basketball with 5:08 to go. And Jamie Parrish still has a little backcourt pressure. Here is Macy Drotzman in the lane to Beeman. Left side, not a three, but a two for Jillian Eisness. All five Gazelle starters have scored now. 69-31, Washington, 4:47 to go. Here's a jumper no good by Washington. Back the other way, Tereshinsky, who fell and pops right back up. That was kind of a scary second right there, Michaels. It looked like she just twisted the wrong way, lost the basketball, but Jillian Eisness helped her up right away. And now Claire will come out and Peyton Mosier back in. So it's Mosier, Beeman, Drotzman, Eisness, and Molly Savvy on the floor for Yankton with 4:30 to go. Washington leading 69-31. For Washington, losing the ball was Grace Peterson. Back the other way, Savvy. Savvy on the right. Down low to Drotzman, who just had a three-point play, but she lost it. A steal by freshman Claire Woods. Right side to Peterson, to Woods, over to the left to Keely Strom. Strom will get a return pass. Yankton, I believe, has gone back to a man-to-man. As we mentioned at the beginning of the game, both teams played man, but that lasted about a minute, both teams. Well, Yankton was first. Both teams went to a zone. Here's a three in the corner, no good, by Washington's Grace Peterson, and the rebound to Yankton with 3:39 to go. And Washington leading 69-31. Washington led 23-6 after a quarter, 48-15 after halftime, and 66-24 after three quarters. Beeman driving in, little baseline jumper, no good. Rebound knocked off the floor by Macy Drotzman. Jordan Salvatore, Ellie Fieser will come back in for Yankton. Back in for Washington, Ava Brink. So on the end line, Molly Savvy will throw it in. Gets it into Salvatore, fouled by Shaylin Fink, her second, team's fifth. So Yankton is a couple fouls away from being in the bonus, while Washington is four fouls away from being in the bonus with 3:18 to go. Salvatore gets the inbounds pass, goes to Savvy. Molly lost the ball, but it's taken back by Salvatore. Goes to Eisness, and the layup from the left side is good. Jillian with 4 points this quarter. 69-33 Washington, 3:05 to go. Down low it goes to Fink. Fink, right side, a three by Claire Woods, no good, and the rebound to Molly Savvy with 2:54 to go. Gazelle basketball on Classic Hits, 106.3, KVHT, Vermilion-Yankton. Shot from the left side by Fieser, no good for the Gazelles. Back the other way, here's Woods from the right side, knocked away by Peyton Mosier. Coming back in for Washington is Bailey Lester. If you really want to know the fact, Bailey Lester is the only Washington player that's dressed that hasn't scored.
Oh.
Coming in for the Gazelles, Camilla Kopp, a 5'10 junior, her first varsity action of the season. Inbounds pass will go to Brink. Here's a runner by Woods that gets knocked away, recovered by the Warriors. Here down low, easy basket with the left hand for Ava Brink with four off the bench this half. 71-33. Sioux Falls, Washington with 2:19 to go. Here is Eisness for three in the corner, no good. Offensive rebound to Fieser in the lane. Here's Drotzman with a jumper, no good. Rebound to Kopp. Kopp has it taken away by Bianca Meeks with 2 minutes to go. And Washington leading Yankton 71-33 on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Here's a pass down low for Ava Brink. Pass was a little too hard from Grace Peterson. Yankton will bring in Cameron Kolecki, a 5'10 sophomore, her first varsity action of the season. 71-33 with 1:50 to go. Across the timeline, Peyton Mosier for the Gazelles. It'll go to Kopp. Kopp loses it out of bounds. It was knocked away by a Warrior. 1:40 left to go. 71-33, Washington. Inbounds pass. We'll go to Feaser. Right side, Mosier for three, no good. Offensive rebound to Kolecki. Kolecki to Feaser. Out front to Mosier. Here in the right corner is Kopp. Tried to get it down low to Macy Drotzman, and it's knocked off the floor. Yankton basketball with 1:25 to go on the end line. Ellie Feaser to throw it in. It goes into Drotzman, scores, and was fouled, and will go to the line for a second time this quarter to try to complete the three-point play. Ava Brink with the foul, her second, team six. Drotzman at the line completes a second three-point play this quarter to make it 71-36 Washington with 1:23 to go. Gazelles will bring in Kylie Medina, a 5'7 sophomore, her first varsity action of the season. Gazelles also bring in Bryn Kenny, a 5'10 sophomore, her first varsity action of the season, and also in Emma Herbolt, a 5'6 sophomore, her first varsity action of the season. 71-36, so everybody that dressed for Yankton getting to play. And here's a drive by Woods with the left hand. Claire Woods has four off the bench to make it 73-36 with 1:11 to go. For Yankton, Mosier to Herbolt. Herbolt stopped on the right side. Here's a steal by Keely Strom at the other end. The layup is good. Strom with her first field goal with four off the bench. 75-36 with 50 seconds to play. Mosier across the timeline. The First Dakota National Bank Gazelle basketball postgame show coming up. Here inside is Medina. Mishandled the ball. Washington the other way. Here's Woods in the lane. Missed the layup. And a tie-up on the rebound. It'll go back to Washington with 33.8 left in the game. And the shot clock is off. Claire Woods will throw it in. Woods will get it into Brink. And the ball knocked around, taken by Yankton with 28 seconds to play. So the Gazelles will go to 0-3. Warriors will go to 2-0. Here down low is Herbold on the block, trying to get a shot off. Can't. And a jump ball. It'll go back to Yankton with 15.6 left to go in the game. And the Warriors leading 75-36. Inbounds pass in the corner. Here's a three that rims out for Kolecki. It'll go to Washington. And Woods will go to Strom. And now to Meeks, and the time will run out. The final score will read Sioux Falls, Washington 75, and Yankton 36. Again, the Gazelles, 0-3, will be next in action next Tuesday night at Aberdeen Central in ESD action. And Michael and I will have that game for you next Tuesday here on Classic Hits 106.3, KBHTRadio.com. And on 5-star streaming from YouTube with tip-off at 7 next Tuesday night, Sioux Falls, Washington goes to 2-0 on the season. Coming up is the Gazelle Basketball Postgame Show brought to you by First Dakota National Bank. First Dakota National Bank, proud of our accomplishments in the communities we serve. And Yankton High School Basketball presented by First National Bank Omaha. FNBO with full-service banking, mortgage, ag, commercial, small business, free checking, saving, and credit cards. Your great big small bank, FNBO. We'll be back after this 3-minute timeout here on Classic Hits 106.3.
R.C. Smith Insurance has been a part of the Yankton community since 1949.
We have several commercial insurance carriers to assist with your business, liability, property, commercial auto, and workers' compensation insurance needs.
We have a wide selection of carriers to help protect your home, auto, watercraft, motorcycle, or long-term care insurance needs.
We take pride in providing you with quality service when you have a claim or need to make changes to your coverage.
Their agency is flexible, or stop by and see them today. 204 West 4th Street in Yankton.
Hyde Piper Flowers and Gifts, your floral and gift store on the corner of 15th and Broadway. We have what you need this holiday season. The freshest flowers and plants, home decor, candles, games, puzzles, socks, a great foodie corner, and of course, beautiful jewelry, because we love things that sparkle. Be sure to stop by and see all that we have. It will surprise you. Shop local, shop Hyde Piper Flowers and Gifts, your floral and gift store.
And neither are funeral homes.
Next time you're thinking of a place to eat, think The River's Edge at 114 Capitol in Yankton. The River's Edge in Yankton offers a diverse and unique menu. And with both indoor seating as well as patio seating overlooking the Missouri River, The River's Edge is a come-as-you-are restaurant. Whether it's for a date night, a day off, or just a quick lunch, you are always welcome at The River's Edge. They feature locally sourced ingredients and classic cocktails. Their menu changes seasonally, so your experience will always be unique. If you're looking to host any kind of event, such as receptions or holiday parties, The River's Edge can help make that evening perfect.
The Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels Yankton has choices for a bride and groom and your wedding reception. Different spaces are available for your wedding reception, and the price is very competitive. Have your wedding reception where they offer you plenty of time for the decorating you and your family want to do, and plenty of time for cleanup, too. At the Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels, you have 2.5-day venue that's all yours. See more by cruising the website, Riverfront and Brewery Event Centers and Hotels.
My reason why is a sense of purpose.
My reason why.
Who can help you undo the damage done by fire or water? Search no further than the experts at Service Master Restore, who have the experience and know-how to make your home feel whole again. For 65 years, we've helped people go from disaster to done. Service Master Restore.
Hey, I think I'll take the day off.
Is your old furnace talking back to you?
You're flying solo today, pal. I need a little me time.
The Kalins Indoor Comfort Pros can repair your grumpy old furnace or replace it with a new high-efficiency Linux system.
Yeah, sorry. I just can't seem to move any air today.
We'll see about that. Get a dependable Linux system from Kalins and start saving today.
Lennox, air is life. Make it perfect.
Back in the Warrior Gym, along with our studio engineer, Casey Miners, our Bucks and Gazelles sponsors on the Yankton Sportscaster Club, along with Michael Schumacher, Joe Van Goor, and in non-conference AA girls basketball, Sioux Falls, Washington, with a big second quarter, defeats Yankton 75-36. Again, the Gazelles go to 0-3 and are at Aberdeen Central next Tuesday night. Sioux Falls, Washington goes to 2-0. Well, in the first quarter, Yankton trailed 6-4. They, trailed the entire game, but they trailed 6-4, but Sioux Falls, Washington went on an 11-0 run and eventually led 23-6 after one quarter. Yankton, down 15 at 23-8, had cut it to 12, but then Washington would lead 48-15 at the half after three quarters. Washington 66, Yankton 24, and the final again, Washington 75 and Yankton 36, Michael.
Yeah, just a rough game from the very beginning. They didn't handle the pressure well, and they weren't getting shots to fall, and I think a certain amount of frustration started to set in with that. But Washington is just a very athletic team. They have a lot of length. They're tall. They're fast. I think they are the best team in the state as far as AA girls basketball goes. So, a loss like this is hard to measure yourself by. They just need to come out strong for their next game and going to put this one behind them, unfortunately.
All right, here's the scoring summary. First of all, for Sioux Falls, Washington, they dressed 13 and 12 scored. Only 5'8 senior Bailey Lester did not score for the Warriors here tonight. But among their starting five, three in double figures. Alexis Motley had 16 points, 13 for Brooklyn Harp. Jackulenga Wentanata had 12, 5 for Hannah Harp, and 1 for Taylor Thompson among the starters. Off the bench, among the top reserves, Grace Peterson had 6 points, 4 points apiece for Claire Woods and for Shaylin Fink, and 3 points apiece for Kelsey Severson and Bianca Meets. Also scoring for Washington tonight, Keely Strom with 4 points, Ava Brink with 4 points. Washington, 31 field goals, 8 of those 3-pointers, 2 by Wentanata, 1 by Harp. Motley had 1. Bianca Meets had a 3. Kelsey Severson with a 3. And Washington from the free throw line tonight was 5 out of 8 for 62%. For Yankton, all 5 starters score, 2 off the bench, none in double figures. Claire Tereshinsky led the Gazelles off the bench with 9 points. Among the starters, Jordan Salvatore, Kate Beeman with 6 points, Jillian Eisness with 4, Ellie Karlovitz with 3 after being in double figures the first 2 games for the Gazelles, and Molly Savvy with 2 off the bench. Macy Drotzman had a couple of old-fashioned 3-point plays in the fourth quarter and scored 6 points. Also playing but not scoring for Yankton, Ellie Fieser, Peyton Mosier, Cameron Koletsky, Camilla Kopp, Emma Herbolt, Kai Lily Medina, and Bryn Kenny. The Gazelles, 14 field goals, one of those a 3-pointer by Claire Tereshinsky, and they were 7 of 9 from the free throw line, 77%. And again, Sioux Falls, Washington, 75, Yankton, 36. Yankton coach Trey Creer joins us on the First Dakota National Bank Gazelle basketball postgame show. And, well, I guess you can safely say, TK, that Sioux Falls, Washington is loaded and we're ready to romp again.
Well, first of all, Joe, your YHS math teachers would be very proud of you for that score sheet you just put together. There's a lot of adding up you had to do there.
Well, let's see. I took Algebra 1, Geometry with Jim Miner, and Algebra 2, and I said that's enough. I did not take senior math with Norm West.
Well, I don't see any
and
variables.
And that's how I graduated from Yankton High School.
I don't see any variables on that stat sheet either, so you're in good shape.
All
yeah,
right.
Joe, you're right. That's a good team. I mean, you even think about just the kids that they brought off the bench and the level of basketball that they were able to play. And we talked to our kids after the game. You know, before the game, we emphasized to them, they're no different than us. They're going to step on the floor with 2 shoes on and a jersey and some shorts. And the biggest difference that is going to be visible is how confident they play and how confident they play from top to bottom. They've had a lot of success. It's easy to be confident when you have success. But at the same time, you know, when you're starting out, you're not going to gain confidence by making shots. You're going to have to make shots because you're playing confident in yourself. And I think that's what we saw in Sioux Falls, Washington tonight. They played a bunch of kids who they all came in and played the exact same way. And that's the level that we want to be able to get our kids to. And it takes work to be able to do that. You know, they didn't step on the floor as freshmen and all of a sudden they were good basketball players. They spent time in June, July, and August. And our kids did too. But at the same time, there's a difference between working as hard as you can and working as hard as it takes to be successful and be good. And we're getting there. And we're getting there in our practices right now, and we need to keep working towards that as well.
Well, Washington just smothers you know, with their press. And, you know, they started off in man but did play some zone tonight. Also, I think, you know, and as evidenced by how many times Ellie Karlovitz hit the floor tonight, they are a physical team as well. They just plain wear you down.
Yeah, and their length makes it difficult, and they take advantage of – every turnover that you get. I mean, there was even times, Joe, where we had a made basket or a missed basket on the offensive end, and they still beat us down to the other end. And it's not for lack of our kids trying to hustle. That's how quickly they play, and
yeah.
that's how they can play with the depth that they have as well. I mean, they're a good team, and they're going to be really hard to beat in the state of South Dakota this year. But, you know, when we talk to our kids, this game isn't going to define us. How we react to this game is what's going to make us better or keep us where we're at. And we got a good opportunity on Tuesday coming up to play another ESD opponent, a team that we think we need to be able to compete with, and our kids are excited about the next week of practice and getting ready for that game before Christmas break.
That's right. Aberdeen Central is next Tuesday, and we'll be with you up there, TK. So, yep, get back in the gym. We'll talk to you Saturday morning on Breakfast with the Coaches on ESPN 101.5 AM 1570 during our Yankton Coaches segment. And we will talk to you Saturday and then see you in Aberdeen next Tuesday. Thanks for joining us.
Sounds good. Thanks, Joe.
All right. Trey Creer, the girls basketball coach at Yankton High School, on the Gazelle Basketball Postgame Show, brought to you by First Dakota National Bank. Proud of our accomplishments in the communities we serve. We'll be back to wrap things up after this three-minute timeout here on Classic Hits 106.3.
Are you looking for the next great career opportunity? Then make it Sherco, a staple of the Yankton community for nearly 30 years. Sherco offers career opportunities in engineering, sales, marketing, accounting, tarp and metal fabrication, shipping, and more. Enjoy a year-round climate-controlled facility, 401k options, affordable health, dental, and vision care, paid time off, and 10 paid holidays. Make Sherco your next great opportunity. Learn more at sherco.com/careers.
The Evergreen Credit Card by FNBO. Earn unlimited 2% cash back on every purchase. Every day. Everywhere. Never worry about expiring points or category restrictions. Plus, there's no annual fee. Only from the Great Big Small Bank. A bank ever ready for you to earn more. Wherever life leads. Evergreen by FNBO.
Perfect night of sleep can be found with Slumberland Sleep Solutions Center. Stearns & Foster, Tempur-Pedic, and Sealy all feature. Don't lose another night of sleep. Stop by Slumberland of Yankton.
Looking to update the family room? Look no further than Yankton Slumberland. Lazy Boy, Flex Steel Furniture, and more. All at your hometown furniture store. That's Slumberland of Yankton.
Boston Shoes to Boots is proud to carry the best brand names in the footwear industry. From tough work boots that are built to last, like Red Wing and Danner, to men's and women's dress shoes from well-known brands like Clarks and Dansko. Or if you're looking for casual and athletic styles, we carry Minnetonka and New Balance, to name a few. We are happy to help you get fitted into a quality pair of shoes. You can find all these brands and more at Boston Shoes to Boots, located on 3rd Street right off of Broadway in Yankton.
Couldn't always attend a world-class...
Imagine working for a successful global business with customers in 140 countries. That's Fache Intertechnology, a Fortune 1000 maker of electronic componentry. Now imagine a company of that size, with that kind of stability, and also a caring, family-like environment. Learn more about what you can do at Fache by visiting www.fachecareers.com. Fache, the DNA of tech.
You deserve to get good service and great rates. At State Farm, we get it, and we're here to help. Because with every State Farm policy, you get good neighbor service and surprisingly great rates. So what are you waiting for? Get going and talk to a local State Farm agent about your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Individual premiums will vary by customer. All applicants subject to State Farm underwriting requirements. When you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Roy Wilcox in Yankton today.
All right, back one more time at the Sioux Falls, Washington gym. Final again on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Sioux Falls, Washington 75, Yankton 36. Sioux Falls, Washington is on the road Saturday at Harrisburg, and let's see here, my poll this week has escaped me, but I believe Harrisburg in the top five in AA girls. Let's check that Yankton Buck score in their season opener against Sioux Falls, Washington, here on the Fox Stop scoreboard. Well, the last score we had, Yankton 56, Sioux Falls, Washington 45, with 4 minutes to go. The Yankton Bucks will be at Sioux Falls Lincoln on Friday night. Michael and I will be there on Classic Hits 106.3 KVHTradio.com, and on 5-star streaming from YouTube. Pregame at 6:45 and tip-off at 7. And a final look now at the Fox Stop scoreboard. The Fox Stop, located on the corner of West City Limits Road and 31st Street, open 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily, a full-service convenience store with gas, diesel, food, munchies, beverages, the cellar, and the video lottery room. Again,
the final for the Bucks was 66-53.
Okay. Well, we'll check those boys' scores in AA coming up. Huron defeated Brookings in AA girls' action in the ESD tonight, 54-41. Watertown leading Mitchell 27-19 under a minute to go third quarter. Brandon Valley defeated Sioux Falls Jefferson 55-49. Sturgis Brown leads Belle Fouche 13-6 start of the second quarter, and I can't believe nobody has an update on this score on this game at all. O'Gorman and Sioux Falls Roosevelt, there is no score available. All right. Again, Michael, the Buck score?
66-53.
Boy, great opening win after being snowed out against Harrisburg, a good team, on Friday night in Yankton. In AA boys action, Belle Fouche over Sturgis Brown, 48-32. Brookings defeated Huron 55-49. Mitchell over Watertown 76-62. Harrisburg leads Sioux Falls Lincoln 69-60 under a minute to go there. Roosevelt leads O'Gorman 23-18, 1 minute left to go first half. Rapid City Stevens and Rapid City Central tied at 15 with 2 minutes to go first half. And Douglas and St. Thomas Moore playing, but no score available from Douglas. And again here, the final 75-36. Again, Yankton led by Claire Tereshinsky with 9 points, six apiece for Jordan Salvatore, Kate Beeman, and Macy Drotzman off the bench. For Sioux Falls Washington, 3 in double figures, Alexis Motley with 16, 13 for Brooklyn Harp, and 12 for Jaculenga Wentanata. Again, Washington is at Harrisburg Saturday afternoon. The Gazelles' next game, next Tuesday at Aberdeen Central in ESD action. And Michael and I will have it for you here on Classic Hits 106.3, KVHTradio.com, and on 5-star streaming from YouTube. Our pregame next Tuesday night at 6:45, tip-off at 7. Thanks to our studio engineer, Casey Miners, and for our Yankton Sportscaster Club members that bring you Bucks and Gazelles games on 5-star communications. For Michael Schumacher, I'm Joe Van Goor. We bid you good night from the Sioux Falls, Washington High School Gym in Sioux Falls, South Dakota.
You've been listening to Yankton Gazelles basketball on the services of 5-star communications and on 5-star streaming. Yankton basketball has been brought to you by our Yankton Sportscaster sponsors, along with our corporate sponsor, FNBO. All high school activities on 5-star communications have been approved by the South Dakota High School Activities Association. We now conclude this broadcast on 5-star communications and 5-star streaming.